In this video, we're going to learn about the Color Manager tool, which is a very interactive way to change the colors of our designs. And to get started, I'm actually going to click on my browser tab, select one of the CMX artworks and double click to quickly create an embroidery design. And here you can see the colors that are involved in our embroidery design. And so the tool I want to use is down here at the bottom of our left-hand color toolbar called the Color Manager. And when I turn it on, it will bring up a little interactive window. And what you'll see, first of all, is here are the 8 different colors that are included in this embroidery design. And here are those 8 colors placed on a color wheel, and they're numbered. Notice that if I bring my mouse outside of this color sort of window over top of the design, I get a magic wand, which if I click on an element of the design, it will highlight that color on the color wheel so that I know what color it is. So if you want to know which color his face is, it's in color number 2, and the dark color of the hat is color number 7, etc. And if you wanted to know what those colors would look like changed, you could simply come onto this color wheel, and where the dark part of the hat is color 7, if I click and drag color 7, I could change it and make it to be brown or purple or red. For that matter, and I'm just going to undo for a moment, I'm just going to point out to you that all of the colors of my design are in the RGB color palette. So that's what they were created in. Of course, we've got many different color palettes available to us, and I could use the Color Manager to quickly convert all of these colors. If I just simply change the palette from the RGB to, let's say, Janome, and now I click on my selection tool again, notice that if I hover over the colors in my color palette, they now are listing Janome colors. So the easiest thing you can do with your Color Manager is change the color palette of an entire design from one brand to another. Another option, let's put it back on the Janome color line, is again selecting the color for the face and dragging it around, and this gives you a real visual representation of what would it look like if we made the dog green, you know, and maybe we could select the red color and make that blue or whatever. So you can get a real sort of visualization of what would those changes look like in your design. I can scroll away if you want to see sort of the whole complete dog like that. And so this is one way that you can interact with the designs, is by changing the colors. Now, you can also use this to reduce the number of colors in your design. So currently it has 8 colors in the design, but what if you decided that you thought maybe you'd like to have the light color blue of the hat and the medium color blue of the hat be the same color blue? You can just click and drag, and it reduces and it displays those 2 colors as the same color. And so now we know what the design would look like if we use the same blue for this and this. And in fact, if I drag the slider down, I can say, what would it look like if I made this a 3 color design? And then you can see how it's combined the yellow and these 3 shades of blue. And if you thought, well, maybe I would have rather had that blue combined with this green, then you can just change it. And so in this way, we can quickly interact with the colors of our design and reduce the colors or increase the colors of our designs. And one final way that we can adjust them is through the harmonies. And when I click on harmonies, it brings up a list of different ways to align colors within a color wheel. And so there are things like monochromatic, complementary, dyad, analogous, triad, square, split complementary, and teradic. Sorry if I didn't say them all correctly. But what if I just click on them, I think we'll see quite quickly what it does. It aligns all of the colors within, in this case, monochromatic, meaning within one single line along a color wheel. And then, of course, they could be adjusted from there. But this allows you to quickly see them with different color theory. So if I choose it to complementary, then now we have colors that are going to be directly across from each other on our color wheel, and you can change that to be dyad and analogous. And so there's several different options available, and it's just a very interesting way to interact with the colors of your color of your color design using your color manager. So that is the color manager and how you can use it to interact with your embroidery design colors.